Hey guys, guess what this video is about?
छोले बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है, smelling very good. अबे पूरी के लिए जगह नहीं है, adjust कर लेना side में.
That's right. In this video, I will be answering questions about the most important thing at an Indian wedding. Almost more important than the bride and groom themselves. It is the one thing that turns your wedding guests into master chef level food critics and your wedding into one big Zomato rating that nobody asked for. You know I'm talking about catering. I am Disha and welcome to Alter Answers, the page we created because I have a problem with asking too many questions and not enough friends to answer them. Without catering, there is no wedding. And a lot of us have already booked our caterers because who would have thought the whole world would have shut down?
I'm sorry, Earth is closed today.
So the first question I have about catering is, I have paid a deposit to my caterer. What happens to my deposit now? To answer this very important question, I have with us the very, very charming Mr. Vevil Lasrado of Family Caterers, who has been in the business for years together. And he has the respect of everyone in the city of Mangalore. So over to you, Mr. Vevil.
Hello.
Hi sir. Isn't he super adorable? Okay, so what do I do about my deposit?
Due to the current situation, many people have postponed their functions. According to me, in my case, if the function would not happen in near future, I would return their deposit.
So he is a caterer with a plan in mind, but I can't say the same for all caterers. They might not agree. So what you need to do is call your caterer and talk to them to see if you can postpone and if the deposit will still hold good. So then I wonder, what questions can I ask my caterer?
Firstly, I would request you all to contact your caterer and discuss about your options, whether postponing your function or reducing the number. Secondly, you can ask, if the function is postponed and if the caterer is not available, will he refund the amount?
That's super important advice, guys. If you have a date in mind for a postponement of your wedding, then talk to your caterer and see if they're available for that day. If you don't have a date in mind, then talk to them and see if they can hold the deposit that you have paid them until that postponement date, okay? But then I have a question in mind. What if my caterer is not available for the date that I've decided to postpone the wedding to?
In that case, the caterer is supposed to refund the amount. In my case, if I'm not available in their postponed date, definitely I would return their amount.
Great. So if your wedding was supposed to be happening in November-December wedding season and you've already planned to postpone, then go right ahead and talk to your caterer and you can ask for a refund. But if your wedding was happening in the next few months, then I don't think it'll be possible for you to get a refund. So what I suggest you can do is talk to your caterer and see what date they are available on. So based on their availability, you can plan your postponed date of the wedding. See guys, this is a very humble advice. These professionals, especially the catering industry, they have staff living with them and they take care of them even in the off season. So that is why I suggest that you be a little considerate as well and then come up with a plan together so that it's a win-win for both of you.
Give me 24 hours.
So my dear COVID-19 brides and grooms, these are all the answers we have about catering right now. If you have more specific questions about catering or about having a wedding in 2020, ask away in the comments below and I will try to answer them for you from the right people. If you like this video and our other videos, please do subscribe to our YouTube channel Alter Answers and follow us and talk to us on Facebook and Instagram. Let's find some answers together.